It's time to put on a new iron condor, this time in July expiration. We're going to look at a regular condor instead of an IC rally, simply because the Russell has already rallied pretty strongly over the past month. It is breaking to new highs right here. It is starting to fade. I wouldn't be surprised, given the kind of reversion we've seen, that into this move, we continue to see reversion and we see a failed breakout. It's very high possibility of that. On top of that, we're coming into the beginning of summer. Summer tends to be a slow time for equities. And so we should expect, you know, even if we've already broken out above this triangle right here, we've already broken out above this. So we can and should expect the overall trend to continue, especially breaking to new highs. But we should not assume that the price action that we saw in January is going to be the same thing that we're going to see going forward. Okay. I think that we're probably going to see higher prices. Odds are we'll see reversion by then, before then, and we'll knock out some kind of a range, chop around, maybe go a little bit higher and chop around again. The idea that we can, in the short term, maintain this kind of trend, all right, so just off of this level right here, I don't think that trend over the short term is sustainable, and we're going to see sellers come in before that. Okay, so this is what the trade setup looks like. This is the July options expiration. These are monthly options. The 15-15, 15.05 put spread for 85 cents. And then the 1720, 1730 call spread at 90 cents. All right, so the total credit on this is going to be $1.75. We're going full size on the call spreads. We've been going half size on our IC rally trades simply because the upside risk was greater, but that was when the market hadn't already moved. The market has moved already, okay? We'll get to the adjustment points here in just a second. This adjustment point isn't right, but we'll talk about it here really quick. Close either side at 30 cents. So if the put spread goes from 85 to 30 on any kind of rally, looks like 5, goes to 30, then you want to take profits. If the call spread goes from 90 to 30, then you want to take profits there. We want to be in and out and grab as much profit as quickly as possible. The ideal scenario here, in my opinion, is basically this. The market pulls back. All right, we take profits on the call side of the iron condor, and then the market rallies a bit, and then we take profits on our put side of the iron condor. That way we can get out with faster profits quickly compared to if we were just hold the iron condor on its own. So this is what the iron condor looks like. And this, I'm looking at a 10 lot here. So maximum risk is 82.50, maximum reward is 17.50. So 17.50 and 82.50, that's gonna be about a 21% return on risk. We're looking to capture about half of this, maybe a little bit more. So we're actually looking to capture between 12 and 15% return on a risk, okay? In terms of the adjustment points, I'll just go ahead and step you through how I'm looking at these adjustment points. To do this, you just go to Delta instead of your profit and loss, and you just look at your Delta right now. And you say, okay, what's the maximum Delta on the upside? And that's gonna be 46.49. Well, what's half of 46.49? That's going to be 23. So where's 23? It's about right here. It's about 16.50. Okay, so 16.52 is our upside adjustment point. And what about the downside? Well, maximum is 38. What's 38 divided by 2? That's going to be, 17, 18? I can't do math while I'm talking. 38, 19. 17. So we look for 19. Where's 19? All right, so we take a look at this, and 19 is going to be at 1566. Okay, now let's see. One other thing to consider. So 1566 is right about here. I don't know where my thickness went up. We'll go. There we go. Okay, that's better. What I want to use instead is this inclining 50-day moving average, and right about where we should expect it. So about 1563 to 1565 is the expectation where we would need to adjust this trade. Now, to adjust this trade, the plan for the adjustment is pretty simple. If we see a move to either the upside or the downside, then what we will do, by that time we will have closed out one side or the other already. But what we will do is go out and buy either a call to hedge upside risk or a put to hedge downside risk. And that adjustment will be on for about a week to, between 5 and 10 trading days. And then if the market continues to move against us, we close out that hedge and then we roll whatever losing side is to either the downside or the upside. And right now, my picture now looks like some kind of a very angry space alien. I just wanted to point that out. He's not happy when iron condors move against him. So that's the basic idea. That's the kind of idea we want to do here. If we see a strong move to the upside and we hit our adjustment point, we'll buy a call. If the market continues to rally, we'll close that call for profits, use those profits to roll the call spread higher, and then add a new put spread. If we see the Russell sell off, we buy a put. If the Russell continues to sell off, we close that put for profits, roll the put spread down, add another call spread. Okay, so the same kind of idea that we've done many times before. So that's what we're looking at. Just to recap, the July 1720, 1730 bear call spread for 90 cents, the July 1515, 1505 bull put spread for 85 cents, total credit 1750. Close out either side of the spread at 30 cents. If we hit our adjustment points, we'll buy some options to hedge half of our delta, hedge 50% of our delta. If the market continues to move against us, we close out the hedge for profits, roll the losing side down, and add another round of spreads that have already been closed out.